Now, in the previous lecture, we already discussed the electrical angle and mechanical angle in a rotating machine. So, this electrical angle and mechanical angle with respect to our previous lecture, it is something electrical angle is equal to P by 2 into mechanical angle. So whatever the mechanical angle measured with respect to the number of slots over the periphery of armature, P is the number of pole, so it will going to convert into the electrical angle. So it is very much necessary to understand what is the electrical angle and mechanical angle in the rotating machine. Yes, so any type of electrical machine, either it may be a DC motor, AC motor, alternator, this concept will remain same. The formula for electrical angle is equal to P by 2 into the mechanical angle. Now today, we are going to consider armature winding. So in case of three-phase alternator, which is a commercial alternator which we are using in a generating plant, armature winding is placed over the stationary part of the machine, and whereas the field winding is placed on the rotating part of the machine. The advantage of rotating electrical magnetic field over the stationary magnetic field, already we have discussed. The salient feature of this one is the easy in construction. Second, insulation, we can provide the insulation very easily. Ventilation, cooling and ventilation is good. And the third is the number of slip rings, or we can say that we are able to collect the current from the stationary part. So there are two types of armature winding. One is the distributed winding and second is the concentrated winding. So the name itself implies that the concentrated winding, the meaning is that whatever the number of armature conductor per phase is accommodated in the single slot. And whereas in the distributed winding, the number of conductors are placed adjacent to the each other, or it is distributed over the periphery of armature. So in this figure, here the figure, it is a three-phase alternator. The stationary part carries the armature winding. It is 120 degree apart to each other. So this is R phase, this is Y phase, and this is B phase. Now, whatever the number of conductor is placed in a single slot, whatever the number of conductor for the Y phase, it is placed in a single slot. And similarly, whatever the number of conductor for the blue phase, it is in that slot. So we can say that whatever the number of conductor we are accommodated, or we try to accommodate in a single slot, which is practically not possible. So in practice, we never use the concentrated winding. But for the simplicity, it is we are going to consider the concentrated winding as well as the distributed winding. So the reason is that we are going to compare distributed winding and concentrated winding. So when we place all the number of conductors in a single slot, so the EMF induced, the magnitude of EMF induced and the phase angle of EMF induced will remain same. So before going to this distribution, we will take a simple example. Example is such that this is the two-phase, this is the two-phase machine is there, or alternator is there. For our simplicity, it is the over the periphery of armature we are placing two conductor. Okay, so one conductor is this is one conductor A, and it's A1 A2. Okay, this may we make a coil, and we are placing a second conductor. We are placing a second conductor is over here. Okay, it is B1 and this is B2. Okay, this is your north pole, this is south pole, and rotor is rotating in this direction. For our simplicity, we are taking this type of here. Now, say for example, this is our EMF induced, which we are going to represent it here. So as the number of conductor or the coil A induces maximum EMF first after an angle alpha. After an angle alpha, say the angle alpha is the subtended points by these two at the center, and this angle is alpha. Okay, so what will happen? The conductor A will induce EMF, maximum EMF induced. It is given by the, say, this waveform for the conductor EA. EMF induced is EA. After an angle alpha, B will be EMF induced. After an angle alpha, B will EMF induce, and the magnitude will remain same. Since both are connected on the same periphery, so it is the EB. Are you getting? So the angle, the difference of this angle is nothing but the angle alpha over here. So it means that if the number of conductor are placed adjacent to each other, the magnitude of EMF will remain same, but the EMF induced by an angle alpha, or whatever the angle which is subtended, or which is will be the slot angle at all, isn't it? So by this way, if you are placing the three conductors, if you are placing the three conductor in such a way that they are 180 degrees to each other, 180 degree, this is 180 degree, one here and second is here, in such a way that it is 120 degree, it is 120 degree apart, and this is again 120 degree. So we can have a three-phase supply, say EA, EB, and EC. So they are 120 degree apart, 120 degree to each other. So this is the, by this way, we are able to produce the three-phase supply. So this is the basic fundamental of EMF induced in the three-phase alternator. Now, our second point to be considered is that if they are the number of conductors, or the conductors are placed side by side, the EMF induced by an angle alpha, or whatever the angle which is due to the number of slots are there, isn't it? Now, suppose if you are placing the number of conductor over here only, in the second conductor, in such way that, so what will happen? The EMF induced in the conductor, their magnitude will be same, the phase angle will be zero. So we can represent it, the phase angle is zero in such a way that it is a one conductor, it is an EMF induced. Second conductor, it will induce the EMF, the magnitude may be different, but the phase angle is zero. So here the phase angle is alpha, okay, because it is with a difference of here the angle is zero, isn't it? So in case of the concentrated winding, the angle between two conductors or the slot angle will be zero. So whatever the EMF induce, they are become zero at the simultaneous, become maximum positive, maximum negative at the same time. So we can say that the EMF induced in these conductors will in phase. So suppose there are three conductors are there, and three conductors magnitude, it is represented by E1, EMF induced by one conductor is E1, EMF induced in the second conductor is E2, and EMF induced in the third conductor is E3, as the phase angle between this one will be zero. So therefore they are can be represented by the straight line, and the total EMF will be a simple arithmetic sum. So E is equal to E1 plus E2 plus E3. So in this case also, we are able to represent the vector with the help of vector diagram. This is EMF induced is EA. After an angle beta, EMF induced. So after an angle alpha, EMF induced in the second conductor is EB. Whereas if they are become maximum at the same time, become zero at the same time, again become maximum negative at the same time, so we can say that the EMF induced is E1, and the EMF induced EA and EB is same, or we can say that E1 is here or EA is here, EB is here. So this is the case of the concentrated winding. So here the concentrated winding, the total EMF is simple arithmetic sum. E is equal to E1 plus E2 plus E3, and it is called as the arithmetic sum. So are you getting this one? I think if you have any doubt, you may ask the question. Yes, anybody?
No, sir.
Okay. So the conclusion is that the EMF induced in the concentrated winding is they are in same phase. All the conductor induces EMF in the same phase. So the total EMF induced per phase is equal to E is equal to the arithmetic sum of EMF induced in each conductor. Okay. So we are considering only one phase so that for our simplicity. Okay. Now here, distributed winding is there. In the distributed winding, the number of conductors are placed side by side in the adjacent slot. Suppose there are number of slots over the periphery. So we can make the angle, say this is your, this is the center, and from the center, it is say, this is the center of X1. Now it will make the second angle. This angle is say alpha, okay? So this angle, again, it is an angle alpha, okay? So we can say that angle alpha, it is a slot angle. So it is called as a slot angle. Slot angle is equal to, what is the total periphery angle? It is a 360 degree, okay? So it is a 360 degree. So we can say that slot angle is equal to 360 divided by number of slots, whatever the number of slots are there. Okay, so it is in mechanical degree. So this is say periphery of armature, whatever the number of slots are there. Suppose there are 72 slots are there. Okay, so if you consider that there is a 360 degree, it will remain same periphery divided by number of slot is 72. So it is equal to 5 degree mechanical. So slot angle is equal to 5 degree. Okay. Now suppose we have taken the number of conductor per phase per pole. There are number of poles are there. It may be a 2-pole, 4-pole, 12-pole, whatever it may be. And for our simplicity, we are considering number of slots per pole per phase is 3, and we are going to calculate the EMF induced in the 3 conductor. So definitely, when the angle alpha is there, they are subtended by an angle alpha. The EMF induced can be represented by an angle alpha. So say this is the, I will represent it with the help of different colors. So this is the angle alpha is there, okay? So this is angle alpha, okay? Similarly, it will make the angle with respect to the other, it is an angle alpha, okay? So this is the angle alpha. Now, the total EMF by this, as they are a vector one, we cannot add a simple arithmetic sum. So we can have E is equal to, this is the vector sum, E1 plus E2 plus E3. Okay, so this is the, it is a vector sum. So we can say that the EMF induced in the distributed winding is vector sum. Now, even though the EMF induced say 1 volt here, 1 volt here, and 1 volt here, so total EMF is will be 3 volt. Whereas, even though the E1 is equal to 1 volt, this is also 1 volt, this is 1 volt, but your vector sum will not be 3, it is less than 3 because it is a vector addition. So because of this difference in distributed winding, the total EMF induced in the distributed winding will not be equal to the vector sum. It is not equal to the arithmetic sum, but it is less than its value. And therefore, the factor comes into the picture, and it is known as a distribution factor. So we will define as a distribution factor. Are you getting? The reason is very simple. in case of concentrated winding, the EMF induced is simple arithmetic sum, and whereas the EMF induced in the distributed winding is not arithmetic sum, it is a vector sum. So the magnitude of EMF induced in distributed winding is smaller than the EMF induced in concentrated winding. Okay, but what is the advantage of distributed winding? So it is quite clear that practically it is not possible to place all the number of conductor in a single slot. Practically it is not possible, one thing. Second, it will make the difficulty in the ventilation, cooling, ventilation, insulations, isn't it? And practically clearly it is not possible. So we have to keep the number of conductor in adjacent slot. Therefore, distributed winding is the practical way we can represent it into the your commercial machines. Okay, so practically we will have only the distributed winding. So therefore, it is much more necessary to calculate the distribution factors. Okay, so distribution factor will be, it is equal to EMF induced. EMF induced. EMF induced in a distributed winding. Distributed winding divided by EMF induced in concentrated winding. Okay, so or you can say that vector sum of EMF induced divided by EMF vector sum divided by arithmetic sum of induced arithmetic sum of EMF induced. So definitely the value of this one, it is always less than unity. Quite clear, because the vector sum is always smaller, slightly smaller than the arithmetic sum, and it is the ratio of vector sum upon the arithmetic sum, and hence distribution factor is always less than 1. It may be a 0.99, 0.98. It is depend upon how many conductors are there and all these things. So I think it is clear, or if you have any doubt, you may ask the question. So just we will take the review or just highlight armature windings two type. One is the concentrated winding, second is the distributed winding. In concentrated winding, we will try to place all the number of conductor per phase in a single slot. No doubt the per phase conductors are distributed 120 degree, but it is not practically possible to accommodate all the number of conductor in a single slot because of the insulation problem, because of the heat and ventilation at all. So we will have a distributed winding. But in concentrated winding, the EMF induced in each conductor is additive. Therefore, the total EMF induced per phase is equal to simple arithmetic sum of EMF induced per conductor. Now, in case of the distributed winding, it is a we are using a practically all type of generator is a distributed winding, where the conductors are placed adjacent to the slots, adjacent in each slots and whatever the number of slots over the periphery of armature. But the EMF induced is slightly smaller because here vector sum we have to consider. Therefore, a factor comes that is called as a distribution factor. And distribution factor is the ratio of EMF induced in distributed winding to the EMF induced in concentrated winding. Or you can say that vector sum of EMF induced divided by arithmetic sum of EMF induced. And this factor is always less than 1. Okay. So here, now we will going to find out the formula for EMF distribution factor. Okay, so again we will consider this. I try to copy the same things. So we will try to find out this all these angles are there. Now suppose we have a this is the center, okay, and from this center we will try to join with the help of lines. So it will make a slot angle alpha over here. So this angle will be alpha, slot angle. This is also alpha and this is also alpha. Okay, now we will take the center of this point. So this will be, what will be that angle? Angle is say it is 3 alpha by 2. This is this angle is or we can say that again we will make one more perpendicular over this section, and this angle is 90 degree, this angle is 90 degree. So definitely this angle will be alpha by 2 over this one. When this angle is alpha by 2, definitely this angle, this angle, total angle is 90 minus alpha by 2. This is 90 minus alpha by 2. Okay. And this is 90 by alpha by 2. Whereas this much angle, this angle is 3 alpha by 2. 3 alpha by 2. So this angle, which is shown by a red line. So this angle, this angle, definitely it is 90 minus 3 alpha by 2. Okay, so this is only the simple geometries are there. We are considering m is the number of slots per pole per face, isn't it? So here we are taking m, small m is equal to number of slots per pole per phase. What is the meaning? Say for example there are 36 slots, okay, and 4 pole generator. So we can say that m is equal to how many slots? There are 36 slots. Number of pole is equal to 4, we have considered, and phases by default is a 3 phase alternator. So we can say that 12 is equal to, this is the 3 number of slots per pole per phase. If there are 72 conductors, it is a 6 slots per pole per phase. But we have taken here m is the number of slots per pole per phase and it is 3. So there are 3 conductors are there, E1, E2 and E3. So EMF induced in this one is the, okay. Now let the EMF induced is E is equal to say it is equal to E EMF induced is equal to E1, E2, E3 is same. So we can say that, okay, we will write it over here. E1, it is E1 is equal to E2 is equal to E3, and say this value is EC. Total EMF induced is, we can represent it this one. Okay. Now we will write as a O. Okay. This is C. This is B. B. And this is point A, and this is point, say, M. Okay. And this point, say, we can represent as a P. Okay. So we can write as a CP is equal to. Okay. We'll grab it. So we can write as a CP is equal to, what is the CP? This is CP. CP is equal to, it can be written as OC, this is O to C, into cos of 90 minus alpha by 2, or it can be written as PB, isn't it? It is equal. PB is equal to, again, OC cos of 90 minus alpha by 2. They are same. So total EC, EMF induced in one conductor. This is OC. It is a CP plus PB, or it is equal to twice CP or twice PB. And it is equal to twice OC cos of 90 minus alpha by 2, or it is twice OC sine alpha by 2. And what is OC? OC is nothing but the, we can say that it is the, EMF induced per conductor. Okay. So therefore, arithmetic sum kya? What is the arithmetic sum? Arithmetic sum is equal to addition of these three. So it is 3 multiplied by EC, or it is 3 into twice OC sine alpha by 2. Okay. Now, similarly, we can say that CM is equal to MA, or CA is equal to CM plus MA. Now, what is the CM? Therefore, CM is equal to. What is CM? CM can be written as, it is the OC cos of 90 minus 3 alpha by 2. Or therefore, CA, total CA is equal to twice OC cos of 90 minus 3 alpha by 2, or it can be written as twice OC sine 3 alpha by 2. Okay. So what is the CA? CA, put it here. CA is the vector sum, and arithmetic sum is this one. So we can say that it is nothing but the vector sum. Now it is very clear. So we can define as the distribution factor. What is the distribution factor? The distribution factor is vector sum divided by arithmetic sum. So what is vector sum? It is twice OC sine alpha by 2, isn't it? Divided by 3. Okay. Divided by 2. 3 into twice OC sine alpha by 2. Now what we have, what is the numerical value 3 comes? 3 is nothing but the m is equal to 3 here. We have taken, that is number of slots per pole per phase. So if it is replaced by m, so your distribution factor, because here OC get cancelled here, OC get cancelled here. Okay, so it is twice OC get cancelled over here. So it is remaining sine m alpha by 2. So we can write as, instead of 3, sine m alpha by 2 divided by m sine alpha by 2. So this is the distribution factor. This formula we will have is the distribution factor. So here m is nothing but 3. Here we have taken 1, 2, 3. If it is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are there. And m is nothing but the 6 over here. So this 3 alpha by 2 comes because of the 3 EMF induced 3 conductors we have taken, a number of slots per pole per phase. So your distribution factor is this value. Okay. So now we will stop here. Now before this one, I would like to take the attendance. Just a minute.